Welcome back from that commercial break. You are still watching Saloon Talk. It is season 3, and guys, we are talking about a lot of things. If you know you haven't been catching up all the episodes, better make sure you go to our YouTube channel, that is Urban Television Uganda. Search up for the other episodes. Make sure that you know what we're talking about right about now. So before we went for the commercial break, we were still talking about divorce and how it affects people, how it affects kids, the parents, and also how it affects the love. So now... the gents to the children, let me start from you before I go to Layla. I'm going to first ask you about your background. Binigata, did you grow up from a stable home or half-half?
Growing up, like really growing up, I grew up with my mom and dad. At least I was blessed enough to see what building a family is. Because it was from... You know, like, my father is a soldier. He's not always home, but he comes back home after some time. So I saw the connection, like the sacrifice of leaving home, and then you go out there to the bush, and then you have to look for food for your family. And then my mom has to sit and wait and also take care of what my father is collecting, because they bring one by one, and then she collects until we grew up. Seeing a family, so I'm happy and blessed to be.
Do you think for all the families out there that did not get a chance to see their parents like together, like while growing up, other people, yes, they have their parents separated when they're already mature enough to understand, but there are those who aren't lucky enough to have parents all the way from like learning your first steps, riding your first bicycle, all that, because it needs both parents around to get mutual love. Do you think divorce these days, like I said, the Ugandan perspective of divorce, it doesn't necessarily mean you have to be married in a church, but our perspective of divorce, do you think it affects the love that the kid shares with like the parents, like one of the parents?
Yeah, most cases, yeah. Because you see, if it's Africa, like Layla said, it's a lot of mixed feelings whenever people break up. So there's that time of people wanting to prove points or people wanting to extend the hurting on behalf of their relationship. They want to use the kid. Sometimes a mom can stop the father from coming to see the kid, or can make it hard. And maybe it could be a situation whereby that kid was already building a relationship with the dad. So you're denied the love, you're denied everything as a growing child that you're supposed to be consuming at that tender age for you to be a better person when you grow up. Because it's a tough world, but we're supposed to be taught by our parents from the very beginning. And the issue of separation also makes it financially hard for these two people to actually grow most of the times, because it's hard for you to plan with someone you're not with in the same house.
True, very true.
I grew up with my mom, but I didn't grow up with my dad. So I'm the only product between my mom and my dad. So growing up, I had so many questions. I was like, why are these two brothers Muslims and I'm not? Until my mom, when we had a conversation, she told me that when I met your dad, in Luganda we called it Kutomeda. Natomeda. How?
Now that's something mean to say to your child.
No. I'm not saying it in a bad way.
Yeah,
but she told me that when they met, he was this kind of guy who promised everything until she got married. Until she got pregnant, sorry. So after, that's when she realized that this guy was legally married somewhere else.
Wow.
He had a family. God. Somewhere else.
I think that's every woman's worst nightmare.
So the only thing she did was to move on with life and got me.
Yeah.
So after getting a son, they were still talking, of course, But she had moved on with life. She got another person, and so that's how I grew up. So I didn't get this
father son bonding.
This love of data. This is my dad. This is because I got to know who my father is when I was in secondary. When I was in Form 3, imagine. That's when I was taken to the village, and this is your chica, these are your people. So I didn't get that love that this is my dad. He comes back home with this. He takes care of me, because all the support was coming from my mom.
From
school fees, from food, dressing, and everything.
Oh, wow. Because so basically your dad did not contribute when it came to your well-being.
Yeah, he wasn't in my life.
Wow.
He wasn't in my life. That's why when I was starting a family, the family I have now, one thing that came into my mind was, at least I want to get, even if there are two children, I want them from one person. Mm. So I want them, at least two people, to share that love of dad and mom.
But actually, it also helps them growing up, being siblings from the same parents, both mom and dad. It connects you so much compared to...
This is because these other siblings connected more than me. And even that connection was deep than the connection I had with them. You understand? So it's not a good thing, that's what I can tell you. And I wouldn't advise someone to just get one kid from someone and then goes ahead, jumps to another, they get kids and all that. It disturbs you mentally when you grow up or when you are growing up. You understand?
Okay, so Nelly, according to your life story, you can feel free not to answer, but according to what you've told us and according to what you went through as a child, do you think right now, because you said you have a child, is it a son or a boy or girl? A daughter? Oh,
yeah.
Wow. Sons, daughters and their fathers, I know. do you think you are a better father than your father was?
Yes, I am.
Why would you say that? Just, is it because you're around, or is it because you give your child everything that your child needs from you?
Yeah, sometimes it's not about giving, but it's about being there emotionally. Because first of all, I stay with her mom, so I am in her life. You understand?
Yeah.
Yes, I'm there every day. And on top of that, I give her all the support she needs.
So you have friends. I know you have very many friends, family friends, close relatives that have not that have grown up from different separate homes. How do you think that has affected their character right now?
Yeah, everyone wants to grow up from a stable together family, seeing your mom and dad together. Like someone mentioned that you cannot love when you don't love yourself. You cannot give what you do not have. So I think, in my opinion, because I have friends that have grown up from separate homes, unstable families, I think it affects them, because maybe sometimes you have to learn things when you're already grown up. But then some of us that are lucky that we've seen our parents together, we can know how to treat the people around us because we've already seen it from our parents. But nevertheless, things happen. I mean, if your parents separated and they were not together, it was not your fault. You just have to learn from the other people that you see around you and know how to love and give love.
So the day you decide to become, are you a mother?
Not yet. I am a mother.
You are a mother? Wow. To a beautiful
stepmother. I'm joking.
Layla. Why are you taking my baby?
Every woman is a mother. I love kids. I have nests.
No, like what I mean biological, like you pushed out your own child.
I'm going to be a mother.
Okay. Now this is where my question comes in. When you become a mother, do you think you're going to be, because obviously you can never know yourself. You can never be like, I'm going to be a good mom, I'm going to do this. But do you think you're going to pull out?
I'm
going
to be a good mother because I love to love. And I love kids and kids love me. And I'm very sure I'm going to be a good mother. Not because out of experience, but I'm going to be a good mother because I love seeing people happy. I love to see love, so I have to give it.
You said you love kids. Yeah. I also love kids. No, there are some kids. There are some kids that you tell something. Now, woman, and you're like, I'm a scar kid. So feel like
it depends on how you raise them and the things they see around. Mm. So if you want your kid to be very soft and good, good-hearted and be behaved, you have to be behaved yourself. And then they will see that kids learn a lot. They're very sharp, more than even the grown-ups.
Yeah.
They do what exactly they see. If you want kids to really be nice or God-fearing, you have to show it. Okay. Yeah, for example, you have to teach them from like a very, very young age how to say sorry, how to say thank you, how to apologize and even love God. One thing I know about, if you love God or if you are God-fearing, there's something that you can't do around people.
Sure.
So, and that will reflect with the people you stay around with. I mean, you stay around and, I mean, the kids. Not even only the kids, everyone around you.
Okay. You guys are going to tell me a general perspective. Before we go for a commercial break, I'm going to leave this question so that you think about it as we go for the break. We have women, or girls. I should call them girls because they're no longer women. People out there, and, you have a female physique. Very many of them live alone, getting married and wanting a property. Very many of them give birth to different, like indifferent men.
Yeah.
Just because, not because there are some that may come from, it doesn't matter whether they come from a stable family or they don't, it's just part of their nature. Yeah, wow, yagala, I want a kid from this guy. And in most cases, you may find that the woman or the girl has given birth in a don, as a demurol, etc. Like, they just give birth anyhow for the mindset, oh, if I give birth to a man, I'm gonna keep him, I'm gonna, you know, get money from him. It's like daily income. I want your perspective on that. Let us go back for a commercial break. When we come back, it's the last segment for today, but we are still talking about this, and like I said, divorce is a very, very, very wide topic. We're not going to cover it all today, but the little we have spoken about, hope you pick a leaf. Let us come back. Welcome back from that commercial break. You are still watching Saloon Talk. I'm your girl Savara Hughes, and in the building, if you've been joining up the show all the way from the beginning, you've been hearing about what we're talking about: divorce, property sharing, how does divorce affect the parents, how does it affect the kids. And the topic is still going on. Feel free to go down to our social media platform, that is Abba Television Uganda, and put in what you have learned, or also give us your point of view on what we are talking about right about now. We are still at Spectra Saloon in Bugolobi. If you want self-care, whether nails, whether hair, whether, you know, massage, whether you're a guy and you want to cut your beard, they have it all right here at Spectra Saloon in Bugolobi. Okay. So, we were still talking about it, but there's a question that popped up in my head, and I wanted to ask. This goes to Binitan. Okay, now I'm going to just bring back a little bit of property sharing. You have a company now called Gantok.
Yeah.
It's becoming an empire slowly, and with due time, it may become something really, really huge. You have not yet popped the question to our woman out there at home, and if at all you guys get married, and you forget to sign the prenup, or it's not even in the package because you guys are in love, like you said, if you're in love with someone, it is very hard to bring up such things. And God forbid, one day she decides, or you guys decide that you are no longer together, you no longer want to be together, and she decides to want to take half of Gantok. What would be your view on that?
Half of Gantok?
Or all of it, depending on what she wants.
I think that's an unrealistic question.
Well, it's marriage and it's part of your company.
You know, it's marriage, but this is a business where I go and work and then come back home. After getting money from the business, I buy some things. So Gantok, as Gantok, is a business of its own. There is some money that I make from Gantok, and I come and buy land and then buy other property. So that's what it's supposed to be, because in Gantok I have my official partners. So legally, there is no way you can get in there.
Okay, Auntie, that comes now. That is within our question, because like you saw the thing of the story of Hakimi and the girlfriend, or the wife, when they separated, she wanted almost everything. And yeah, you have made it.
Yeah,
So that means you separated. No, you separated Ganto.
There's some things I don't have to worry about because I'm an African. Because at the end of the day, I'm never going to be a white man. Yeah. And I don't want to follow the system. No, I just want to follow what is right and what is within glorifying the Creator, that is God. Because as a man, I don't want people to tell me so much about love and relationships. Because as a believer of Christ, I know my role, what I'm supposed to be doing in a family as a man.
If you're dating with someone, most cases you're getting out with your friends, your girlfriend, and you said, Leila, you're with someone new and he's treating you right, and you guys go out with your girlfriends, and then one girl comes and tells you, by the way, be careful with that man, I see him with this one. You may even find he's not doing anything. It's just, they just don't want to see you happy. So I think you're right. Most cases, relationships are hindered by, I think right now I'm going to say majorly social media, because Katiabantu to these days I've had friends that have done kwanjula just for Instagram pictures. Oh,
so many.
Just for Instagram. Okay, so we're about to end the show, and I'm going to be asking you guys what you are doing currently in your music careers, what we should expect. But before I go, a piece of advice to someone out there, or a lady or a man out there that wants to be ready for someone, like, let me say, if someone comes along and treats you right, wants you to get married, and you're not ready, what piece of advice do you give that person?
No, I think for me, let me go first. I think when it comes to that, you should always have a picture of your own life setting, because you see, things to do with marriage, it's trying to merge our personal interests in the future. Like, what do you like, what do I like, yeah? So with that, you can easily tell, okay, in my future, I want to be a married guy with a stable family, I have children, I want to build a house like this, I want to do businesses like this. Then you're gonna find you may like someone, but when you have different dreams and different ambitions. So when you come together, that's where the colliding starts from most of the times, because you don't share the same vision. There is love, emotions, feelings, but now the future. What do you have in your future? What do you want in your future? Is what I want in my future the same thing that you want in your future? Because these are emotions. After emotions, there's going to be reality. You must be able to live with someone, not because of only feelings, but because they are a part of you. They are even a part of your future that you've not yet even lived as yet. Because you can speak about it. You can see things like, yeah, I can see myself with my wife 20 years. Because even now, we talk about, when Joshua is this age, we want to be like this. At this age, we want to do this and this, if God wishes. Yeah, so I think you should fall in love with someone who you share with the same dreams, kind of.
And also, I think in this generation, we have to be clear with our intentions, especially when you get someone, when you are in a new relationship. It's always good to be clear that we are in this because of this and this. I've just came to have fun with you, you know. It's always good, not just promising someone that I'm going to love you and in 10 years we shall be having kids and all this, we shall be, because at the end of the day, it won't make sense in the long run. You understand? If you want to have fun with someone, be clear. Okay, njagala tunyumidwemu for some time. But because that's how, and to be honest, sometimes relationships are built from there.
From the fun,
yeah. Yes, from the fun. Because you start learning someone, then you know.
Falling, not falling. I don't want to fall, but I'm falling.
Yeah, but it's always good to be clear.
Yes.
Yeah. So Leila, what's your piece of advice?
My advice would be, take your time. It's not a competition. Take your time. Fall in love with your friends. Fall in love with someone that really, really understands you, and like you have the same vision and same goals. And love cannot be defined. Something I like might not be the same test for you. So this is something that is natural, God-given, that will come automatically. You do not chase love. Love has to come and chase you. So finding love is very easy. You just have to open your heart to it and it will come to you. So it's not a competition. It's not like how you said that social media is really pushing a lot of people to have kids that they don't want to have weddings that they do not even, they don't have interest in. So you just have to relax and sit back and things will fall in their place in their places because you have a good intention and what you like exactly.
Okay. All right. So I think we're going to pause that for now because, man, the topic of divorce and it can pop up some memories. You know, some of us, Munaya, did not grow up from. Anyway, that's a story for another day. So, Layla, you're going to tell me what you're doing currently in your music career, how many songs you produced this year, and then also future projects that we should expect and the fans out there should expect.
I don't really like talking about things that I've not yet released, but definitely I'm in studio. I love music. Music will always be my love and my passion. So all that time, lockdown, the songs that we did in studio that we'll be releasing. I have another song with Chameleon. I have another song with Justede. So slowly, and probably I'm praying, hopefully this year, a full album will be out.
Okay. Yes. We should expect like an album release party.
Anything can happen with Commando anytime.
Okay, Bini Ganta, same question goes out to you.
Yeah, basically Gontak is on a tour. We are doing a country tour. It's a Gantok Fest tour, Bini Ganta plus friends in tour. We're gonna be in Fort Porter on the tour. So and then we have new music out. I have Ntwala Ntwala video is out. It was shot by Switch On Visuals. We have strong partnerships as Gantok right now, as a family. We have House of Creatives as part of us. So it's basically now we are unleashing things that we've been working on, starting with Ntwala Ntwala video for this year.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so Nelly, same question also goes out to you.
I'm working on a lot, first of all, I'm running an international hip-hop MC challenge called End of the Week. It's a competition. In Africa, it's only in Uganda, South Africa, and Nigeria and Madagascar. So I'm responsible for Ugandan champion every year. We had stopped because of COVID. We last represented at the international level in 2018 in Paris, France. But this year I'm working on organizing the competitions again to pick a Ugandan champion. And we might be able to represent either in USA or England. On the other side, I'm working on my third album, which will be dropping this year. Yeah, I've been working on it for the past 3 years. But it will be dropping this year. And music, yeah, I've been releasing wrap-up songs every year. Like, I wind up all the news and come up with the wrap-up single every end of the year.
I've actually gotten a chance to listen to one of the biggest one you had, the wrap-up, I think, of
2020.
Yeah, that one.
Yeah,
listen to also. I was like, wow.
Yeah, but I'm also releasing new music. I realized that hip hop fans, Mugamba Nyo, that Twebaka. So, this album is going to be a bit collaborative with the people doing different genres. So I have a new single dropping in 2 months with APUS. The reason I'm doing with these people outside hip-hop is because they have a bigger following than us. So I want to tap into their fan base as well and then, yeah, create something fused with hip-hop and maybe dancehall sounds, maybe Afrobeat sounds or anything. Okay. Yeah.
All right, guys, we have reached the end of the show, but don't worry. If you know you still wanted Leila or Bini or Nelly to say something else, we shall have them on another episode depending on their schedule and the time that they have for us. But anyway, guys, see you next episode. That is next Sunday. Join in on Urban TV on 8 p.m. up to 9 p.m. We're going to be here just an hour. Don't worry. Just pick an hour of your day. We are going to be telling you about the different topics that go on in the world. My name is Savara Hughes. You can feel free to follow me on all my social media platforms. That is Savara Hughes 53. See you again next week, same time. Bye.